Trying to reach in here is not easy, but hey, one less leaf. Looks pretty good. I just have a stick in my knee. That felt good. I'm going to try and kneel down here, but this is a slope. So if I do a backflip, you might want to do a screen capture because I've never done a backflip before. But I have eggplants in here. Don't know what kind. I just know that somebody sent me some seeds and I decided to grow eggplants. They are potted eggplants. I grow them in a pot and I just use regular potting mix like I do inside, only I feed them compost tea because when you grow in pots, you want to make sure that you feed your plants a little bit more than you do in regular soil because they're trapped inside whatever soil you decided to give them. And if you don't give them really good soil, or if you just assume that they're going to survive there the whole season, you're mistaken because you have to keep feeding them. And that is the key. That's what I do for these things. I keep feeding them. And my door blew open. Lovely. So it's windy out here today. We had a storm. We have a storm about every day now. But before the next storm blows in, let me finish this. I put a little fence around here because we had that windstorm that came through and was blowing everything all over the place. It was just nasty. And I learned my lesson. I put a little bit of fencing around here and it keeps them from blowing away. But I want to make sure that there's enough airflow coming through. Oddly enough, I mean, it's ironic that I want enough airflow to come through when I have such a windy area, but it's true. I'm going to show you what I do to keep the airflow in here, to keep these plants from getting any kind of fungus, and also to allow pollinating insects to come in. Let me show you. This area in here was filled with leaves, and I noticed that some of the leaves were starting to get a little bit of a fungus, either early blight or some other kind of fungus. Who knows? There's a billion different kinds. I don't try to keep track. All I know is it was a fungus. The leaves were looking awful. So what I did was I took my old pruners. I have a lot of nice, expensive pruners, but you know what? I keep coming back to the old rusty ones. I don't know why. They just feel good in my hand. You know what I mean? You always have this favorite pair, and that's what I have. So I reached in there, and I cut out the leaves down towards the bottom. That can allow the airflow to come in, but also look, see, we have flowers down here, and I don't want a whole bunch of leaves here blocking the pollinating insects from seeing that. Otherwise, I'm going to have less of a harvest. And this, by the way, goes true for just about anything you have. If you have foliage that's way, way thick, you might want to trim a few of them out there so that some air can get through, and also to let the pollinating insects know that there are flowers in there, because some of these plants have subdued flowers. And this thing is doing fantastic. Let me show you something. We have a little flower down there. Actually, they're not very little at all, but when they get pollinated, the flower falls off, and you see this little tiny thing in there. See? Yep, I got me an eggplant. I don't much care for eggplant as far as flavor or eating, but I love growing these things. They are a beautiful, beautiful plant. Yeah. I don't mind weeds around my garden, but you know one thing I really don't like? I cannot abide thistle. I don't like thistle because you're pulling weeds, and yeah, here I am ranting around my strawberries because I want to sit down, get my fat butt down. Hi. That was indelicate. Yeah. Hey. You like strawberry? Oh, looks like something else likes this strawberry too. Red. That is just a really beautiful thing to see in the garden when you're in the strawberry patch. If you see it anywhere else, you probably accidentally nicked your thumb and you're bleeding. But this one got bit, so it's a totem. Yeah, we'll put it right here, and I'm going to give it to the chickens later. Nothing goes to waste out here. Take a look at the strawberry patch. I want to show you something because I want to show you how I do my strawberry patch before it starts raining, and I think we've got a few minutes, so let's hurry up and get this done. The plants are doing fantastic. What I did was I planted the strawberry plants about maybe a foot apart in here. And then as they, after a strawberry plant fruits, it will generally send out runners. There are different kinds. There's everbearing, there's June bearing, there's some other kind, day neutral, and all three have different fruiting and runner patterns. This kind, the kind that I normally get, what they'll do is in the spring they put out the green growth, then they put out tons of flowers, then they put out the strawberries, then they're done with the strawberries. Then they put out runners like you wouldn't believe, and possibly in the late summer, you'll get a few more strawberries, but generally you get them early off in the season. But these are about done putting out their strawberries, and I wanted to show you how I propagate my strawberries so that you can get the most use out of your strawberry patch. One thing you do want to make sure is that you keep your strawberry patch weeded for the first year or two. After that, believe it or not, your strawberries do most of the weeding themselves. They will block out everything because they'll be so thick in here, you won't have to worry too awful much, just a little bit of weeding. So take the effort, weed them for the first couple years and you won't be sorry. Whoops, there's a weed. Speaking of weeding your strawberries, anyway, I went through here and I weeded these because I wanted to show you up close and personal what these do. They're done putting out the strawberries. And now what they're putting out is what's called runners. You can take a strawberry, by the way. Let me pick one real quick. It's dirty, but it's a demo strawberry. Normally, strawberries have these little white dots. Hey, look, a bug. Get off of me. Anyway, strawberries will have these little white dots. Those are seeds. Some people say they're not seeds. Yes, they are. The way that I planted mine when I did them from seeds is I just threw a bunch of old soft strawberries that I didn't want to eat into the blender. Blend them up really slow. Add some water, and then just kept dumping out the water, adding more, and then finally the seeds settled at the bottom, and I planted those, and I got strawberry plants. But most people don't want to start them from seeds. We get them from roots. You plant the roots, make sure that the crown is right there at ground level, not too awful deep. You don't want to bury it too much because that'll cause it to rot. And then your strawberry plant goes nuts. It is absolutely beautiful. And I showed you how I planted these by splaying out the roots. Now, the next step is runners. What a plant will do is it'll send out this stem with a little plant on the tip of it. A little tiny plant at first. It'll send it out and it'll be up in the air. And just leave it alone. It'll just keep growing and growing and growing and eventually it'll touch the ground. Now leave it. Once it stops sending out length, this will put out roots. See that? Take a look. Yep. Let me get my hand out. I'm a big old white hand of mine. Yep, when it hits the ground, it'll put out roots. And what it's doing is it's starting a whole new plant. And what you can do at that time is you can take this and maneuver it wherever there's an empty spot because they're not always on a convenient spot. And sometimes you'll have two runners putting them down at the same place. You don't want that. You want your strawberry plants at least 6 inches apart. And eventually it's going to get too crazy. These are going to be really, really in here. But for right now, I have the room. So you just place it there. Onto the soil. Actually, let me move you over to the left. You find where you want to put the strawberry, take your finger, and make sure that the soil is moist when you do this. Place the runner in there, and then put soil over the stem. And if you want to make sure that stem stays in there, put a little rock on it, or take a paper clip and put it upside down, and then push it into the soil. Anything to hold that down and put a little soil on it, but leave the cluster of leaves showing. Leave it like that. And you will have yourself a brand new strawberry plant. What this little runner is doing is it's drawing off the mother. This is an umbilical cord, that's all it is. It's a lifeline. Even though it has roots, it's drawn all of its energy off the mother plant. Once it puts roots down, it'll start sending down those roots and you'll see all of a sudden a growth. And once that plant starts getting bigger, just snip off the stem here, snip it off close to the mother plant, throw that stem away. But there's another surprise. Take a look up close. See, this runner, before it even started growing too awful much, it put out another runner. Yes, this is an exponential effect. You will have strawberry plants putting out about a half a dozen runners. This thing has one, two, oh, there's another one, three, oops, starting another one, four runners, and each runner will put out a new plant, and then each runner will put out more runners. So one plant is gonna form about maybe 8, 9, 10 plants in 1 year. One plant turns into about 10 plants. So I have about a dozen or more plants. We're talking 120 plants, yes. And if you wanna give these to your friends, what you do is you can put a little cup of soil and put this in the cup of soil, let it put down roots, and then once you see that the roots are growing in here, snip it off, give it to your friend, and they can take it to their house and plant it. If you snip it off right here, and just take the roots. Sometimes it'll root, sometimes it won't. For a surefire rooting with absolutely no risk whatsoever, do like I said and place it just under the soil to where the green is showing. Put a little soil on there. Wait about maybe, I'd say 2 weeks, and then you'll notice that this is growing like mad. That means that the roots went down there. Keep them watered, not soggy, just moist, and then when you're done, snip, snip, you are all set to go. And that's all there is to propagating your strawberries. Yeah, what the heck. While we're here, let's look at the asparagus. Look, little berries. I call them asparaberries. And what that is these are seeds. Yes, when you have asparagus, let me look at this one right to the right of it and see if I can get up close without shaking the camera too much. See these little things right here? Yep, those are flowers. Little itty bitty things, inconspicuous as heck, but you'll see them all over some of your asparagus. Those are flowers. They will be pollinated by a billion pollinating insects. And then you will have green berries all over the place. Let them stay on the plant until they turn orange or yellow, and you'll actually see them starting to fall. And if you're quick, get out here, gather these boogers up when they're orange, take them inside, put them on a paper plate in the window, and let them dry. And these will have seeds inside. This is a seed pod. That's all it is. And then you can dry them, save them, and then in midwinter, you can plant these in little cups in your house and start your own strawberry plants. I did this a few years ago and keep these asparagus very well fed throughout the summer. I've been giving these compost tea like you wouldn't believe, and they start out with one shoot coming up, then they turn into these fronds. I just let them go, and then as they go, more and more new growth will come out from the ground. And that's a good thing. You know, for the first year, you may just get one frond, two fronds. Sometimes you'll get lucky and get a whole boatload of them. But it doesn't mean that you're failing if you only get one or two. Let them grow. They will take their time. Trust me. In time, you will have so much asparagus, you won't know what to do with it. Your friends won't know what to do with it. It's a wonderful thing. No such thing as too much asparagus, is there? Asparaberries. I love asparagus. No such thing as too much. I have a little bed of asparagus here, approximately 4x4, and then a strawberry bed that's a little bit smaller. I used to have some planted out here, but they were so crappy. I remember mentioning these in a previous episode. They were so crappy, I didn't even keep them. I just let the weeds take over and I mowed them and stuff. I'm eventually gonna make another bed and connect it onto here and bring in some compost and do it the right way. And I'm gonna take more strawberries and bring them out here, or get some more asparagus roots and plant them out here. I haven't really decided how I want to work this. I'll just play it by ear. That's usually what I do. And I love these asparagus berries too. I'm going to be gathering some of these up later on. But whether it's strawberries, asparagus, what are those things? Eggplants. I hope that you got some kind of information up here that you can use and it'll help you in your garden. I got to get going. I'm going to get rained on, and so are you if we don't get in the house really quick. So this is Ray out at the garden. Thanks everybody for joining me. I really do appreciate it. Have a great day. Bye.